I've got something fun to show you guys today. This is the Beelink SEi 12 mini PC. This is a little beast of a machine, and when I say little, I mean it. I mean, this thing is small. Look at this compared to the Steam Deck. I mean, this is really tiny. Now, I've got several mini PCs around the house, and this is by far the smallest. Most of them are preoccupied, that's why I don't have them here on my desk to show you. But this is like 80% the size of the smallest competitor that I've got here, so it's perfect for a variety of use cases. It's got a 10-core Intel Core i7-12650H, 32 gigabytes of RAM, a 512 gigabyte SSD, Wi-Fi 6, and a gigabit NIC. And those are some pretty impressive specs for a device this size. It's perfect for little indie games and older AAA titles, but modern games are a little sluggish. Even the well-optimized Doom Eternal struggles to keep a stable 30 FPS on this thing. However, most of the other games that I've tried have worked great. Like I said, you're gonna be playing older titles or indie games, something that isn't too graphically demanding. Now, in terms of the chassis, it's this beautiful navy color. It's got a soft fabric on the top, which somehow I dinged and I don't know how. I have a loose thread now. It also has a decent amount of I/O. On the front, it has two USB type A ports as well as a type C port. This is Thunderbolt, but there's no power delivery. And then it also has the power button and a tiny recessed CMOS clear button. On the left and right, we have some grills for cooling. And then on the back, we have the aforementioned gigabit Ethernet. We have two USB type A ports, one HDMI, one display port, and the power jack, of course. Now this little nuc-like runs especially quiet, even when I was fully stress testing the thing. Even at max load, I could barely hear the whisper quiet fan spinning. Now for the internals, I tried taking this thing apart, but after taking the bottom cover off, I was kind of stumped as to how to proceed. I didn't see additional screws and the documentation didn't really show me how to do it, so I kind of closed the cover and stopped right there. On a positive note, it is possible to upgrade the RAM in this device. However, getting to it is another story. So I also installed a SATA drive, which you can do just by opening the bottom cover. That was a very simple process. But let's be real for a second. All of this is well and good, but seeing as this ships with Windows, I know you're probably wondering, how does this thing fare with a good operating system on it? Well, you're in luck because I've tried ChimeraOS. Now, before we get into that, I want to take a moment to recognize the generosity of my patrons. They make this show possible, literally. I've just launched my own video streaming site. It's called subscribe2.me, and it's because of my patrons that I was able to do this. It's part of the Fediverse too, so you can subscribe from your favorite Mastodon instance or even an RSS client. Remember RSS? I do. It's because of my patrons I've been able to do this. So if you like open stuff and the Fediverse, consider making a pledge over on Patreon. And thanks. So let's talk about ChimeraOS. It runs Steam in Steam Deck mode, and I was actually surprised how well this worked because, hey, this thing has Intel graphics. And that means that this device is not without its quirks. We'll go over them. Quirk number one, and this was the very first issue that I encountered actually, is the Wi-Fi chipset. Well, ChimeraOS's installer does not seem to support it. So in order for me to actually get Chimera up and running, well, I had to run a Cat5 cable from my network closet to the cart I have this set up on. It also is not supported in game mode, but I noticed that Bluetooth seemed to work. So I dropped into desktop mode and lo and behold, there was the Wi-Fi connections that I was looking for. What the issue is with Big Picture Mode and Chimera installer, I really don't know. As long as you've got a cable, you can get Chimera set up and then you can drop into the desktop and connect to your Wi-Fi. It's not that big of a deal. Quirk number two, these Intel graphics drivers? Yeah, they don't like HDR. Enabling it from the quick access menu halved my performance. And quirk number three, interestingly, for some reason, variable refresh rate provided an extremely uneven experience. Most of the time, games took advantage of VRR without any complaint, but for some reason, in Metal Gear Solid Phantom Pain, when VRR was enabled, it introduced a huge amount of lag. I'm not really sure why. Quirk number four, sleep and resume while in game is a bit inconsistent. This could be the Intel chipset, I'm not really sure, that's just a hunch. There are several games where it works great, but then a few others refused to resume and just sat at a black screen after turning the device back on. Quirk number five, there's no audio over HDMI unless you drop into the desktop and manually enable the HDMI output for audio. For me, it seemed to stick after I did that, so I was able to set it and forget it. but it was kind of obnoxious to deal with. Now, as anyone familiar with Linux knows, most of these issues will get ironed out in the next 3 to 6 months. Basically, just wait for the next release of ChimeraOS and you probably won't encounter any of these issues. But there's one glaring issue that likely won't get resolved in a few months' time, and that problem is shader compilation. If I had a nickel for every minute I spent waiting for shaders to compile, I would have had like a few dollars by now at least. I mean, I get why this happens. It's because the GPU needs the game's shaders cached and ready to execute while playing the game. Otherwise, you end up with, you know, extreme stuttering when an uncached shader is compiled while you're playing. But it's a very slow process, and seeing as this is not a widely used GPU, that means that there aren't going to be many folks who've already done the hard work here and uploaded their cached shaders to Steam. And look, this isn't a problem with this device, right? It only happens when you launch a game for the first time anyway, but still, it's annoying. Now that we've got all the quirks and issues out of the way, how is the performance on the SEi 12? How well does this thing actually run games? Well, like I said at the top of this video, it's a beast of a little device. It can run older AAA games without breaking a sweat, at least at 1080p or under. And of course, it's got you covered when it comes to indie titles too. Another bonus of using ChimeraOS though, I was able to connect my SD card reader and insert my Steam Deck's 1 terabyte card. Guess what? Steam just discovered all of the games that I had installed there, and Linux is just wonderful like that. And it's also great for emulation. Here I have a subset of my collection. Not every console works great. Zemu and Xenia don't fare too well. RPCS3 works, but only for some of the lighter games. But Dolphin was pretty performant, and everything else I tried worked great. I was able to install EmuDeck on here quite easily, though it wasn't quite as simple or straightforward as it is on the Steam Deck. When I first got it installed, Steam ROM Manager refused to boot for some reason. So I installed the Flatpak from the ChimeraOS App Center, and then I ran that, but that didn't have any of the correct runners installed. So I went back to EmuDeck's Steam ROM Manager, and then that somehow resolved the issue. Then I just pointed it at the ROMs directory on my SD card and it handled all the hard work for me. Now overall, I really like the SEi 12. The form factor is nearly unbeatable. It's great for many of the types of games that I enjoy playing. Now if you want to pick up one of these devices, there'll be a link in the description. It's an affiliate link, of course. Just so you know, I want to give you a heads up on that. But this is a great little PC and I had a lot of fun with it. That's gonna do it for this video. Don't forget to check out subscribe2.me where my next video is already live. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.